game all last night to some more fun stuff. We talked about Hornqvist's hat trick in the Penguins game. This is the fastest hat trick in Pens history. 2 minutes, 47 seconds as the Penguins beat the Avs 6-3. And I gotta say, there's been a lot of hat tricks in Pittsburgh already this season. So let's just take a little trip down memory lane, perhaps.
Yeah, Brian Boyle did it in Pittsburgh.
On Hockey Fights Cancer
Hockey
Night.
Hockey Fights Cancer Night. He had the hat trick there. Big nice. Brian.
Then we had his wife in and talked about how special that night was for her.
That's right.
And then Braden Point doing his in a minute something, I believe.
Yeah, minute 21.
That will not be his last hat trick of the year. I'll tell you that for free. He's on fire.
I like when you give away things for free.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, that's always fun. You're like,
very
Oprah.
Very generous.
Generous, yes.
Yeah, clearly. And then,
funny,
of course.
These three, the last two goals hit about three things. It was like the luckiest two to get in. Both shots that were deflected ended up getting in. But still, incredible. 247, and not your season can change, but all of a sudden your goals. Say you have 9 goals, all of a sudden you got 12 in 2.5 minutes. You're like, what just happened?
Yeah, you climb up the ranks.
How is this so hard sometimes? Because that was easy.
Hat tricks are always a good time, but this one, we've had a couple in a very short span of time in the NHL. Obviously, Hornqvist in 2 minutes, 47 seconds. Yeah. Every day on this show, at some point during a commercial break or maybe right before the show starts, EJ will go to the Say Hey Cafe, which is the cafeteria here at NHL Network, and he'll get himself a tea. Rightfully so.
Yeah.
It's cold in here. It's, you know, nice to have a hot beverage.
Good for the throat, yeah.
It's just down the hall, but I wonder if you can go there, get your tea in 2 minutes and 47 seconds or less. So,
okay,
I mean,
so
if you're up for the challenge, I think that, but you, I mean, don't run down the hall. Like, go it's a
I'll
real day.
I'll go like
day.
I would normally go.
Yes, all right? Exactly.
I don't know if you can.
Can we get the clock up?
Get the clock.
Can we get the clock? Can we get 2:47?
I am slow. I mean,
okay, we're good.
All right, well. There you go.
Start it.
See ya.
Leaving his notes and everything.
See ya.
All right. See ya, Ej.
I don't know if he can do it.
In the meantime, you think he can do it?
Well, I see him constantly. He takes like 25 minutes to put the tea bag in, and then he's pouring the milk. So I don't know what's going to happen.
And he's, I mean, we all know here at the network, EJ's pretty chatty.
That's
so
the problem.
If he's
going to see somebody like, be like, oh, what are you hearing on Panarin? What are you hearing on Makovsky? And then he's just going to forget we sent him to get tea. But
he's walking with pace, though, right there.
The new Say Hey Cafe, we should, well, maybe not that new now, but still. Beautiful cafeteria area for us here.
In the meantime, we got time to kill because we can't play-by-play the tea game all day here.
No.
A couple other hat tricks in the league last night with Cam Atkinson.
Yeah, and it's unfortunate when you get a hat trick and your team loses 9-6, but still for him, this is a guy who's had a great season so far, connection with Panarin, and he's looked fabulous. So some three awesome goals last night in a tough loss.
You know what's crazy for Atkinson? 11-game point streak for him. He's on a tear.
Quiet 11-game point streak. So somebody that was re-signed last year and is deserving the money he got.
And Franz Nielsen as well with the hattie last night.
Yeah, Detroit with looked like they had this game a couple different times, and Tampa's just so hard to keep down, but Franz Nielsen was great all game, and you see this goal right here kind of ended it. That's one that you know it's your night when you get your third goal on a puck that just bounces to you in the slot. So a perfect shot by him, just a tough ended up being a tough loss for the Red Wings.
Well, I can see EJ still putting whatever he puts in his tea in there.
Is he actually gonna get this done?
I don't know. I would have pegged him as a coffee drinker, but he enjoys his tea, and fair enough.
Oh, he's
confident now.
He probably started a clock or something. I'm sure he knows that he's got plenty of time to spare.
Is there going to be a koozie celebration when he gets in here if he beats the clock?
Well, we have to ask him if he actually paid. Did he pay for that?
Oh, yeah, I didn't see him pay.
I didn't see him pay, EJ. Where is he?
What kind of scam is he operating around here?
Yeah, now he's getting real caught.
Oh, he's having trouble with the door. It's a push, not pull.
The fact that Hornqvist had 3 goals in the National Hockey League in this amount of time is a joke.
It is. Okay.
Yeah.
Did you pay?
That's my tea. I never pay for it. It's my own tea bag.
You don't have to pay for the cup.
They don't ask me to pay for the cup.
Wow, big.
I like how you guys are trying to paint me as some cheapskate.
What,
on national television.
Wynn asked the question.
Yeah, I'd like you to throw him right under the bus.
Yeah, of course.
Wynn asked the question.
I'll take it.
He's only here a couple days a week. Yeah. I got to deal with you more.
Every day.
You know.
Yeah, that was, I could have done, I'm surprised I did it that quickly, to be honest.
That was a nice little spin move on the way up by you.
I was feeling it at that point.
Well, clearly.
I knew I was in good shape.
I'm just lucky you didn't trip and take a tumble like producer Collins, because then it would have been a disaster zone.
Well, it would have been bad, but it could have been good TV, which we always like. So.
And as he yells at me, all right, wrap this
Let's
up.
Let's move on.
It's time to move on.